We begin our program with a question regarding the New Age movement. This listener writes, "The New Age teaching has become widespread and invasive. Could you explain the ramifications of this movement?"
Now, I have here a clipping taken from a local paper, in fact, one of our Los Angeles papers, and it is a clipping by a Presbyterian preacher by the name of Wilson. And I would like to read some of the things that he has said about this cult. He says, on April the 25th, 1982, a full-page advertisement was seen in every major newspaper in the world. The headline proclaimed, "The Christ is now here." On January the 12th of this year, a similar full-page ad was seen in USA Today. Again, the title was, "The Christ is in the World." Who is this Christ? Recently, when Sharon Glenn won an Emmy for Cagney and Lacey, she gave credit in her speech for the second year in a row to Lazarus. Who is this Lazarus? And Oprah Winfrey had on a recent show several proponents of the New Age movement. She enthusiastically supported their message. What is the New Age movement? The Los Angeles Times magazine of September the 7th had on its cover, actress Shirley MacLaine. The article called her the super saleswoman for the fast-growing New Age movement. What do these things have in common? They are all a part of what is called the New Age movement. Most Christians I know have ignored the above, suggesting that the people involved have a screw loose somewhere and are not to be taken seriously. I assure you, it's not a joke, and I think it is about time Christians took their heads out of the sand and took a serious look at the New Age movement. The New Age movement is calculated to inaugurate a new world government and a new world religion under the reincarnated Christ, whose name is Maltreys. He is alive in the world, soon to appear. The New Age plan is to see a revival of mystery cults, sorcery, occultism, and immorality. Spirit beings such as Lazarus will help to inaugurate the New Age and pave the way for the new world teacher. New Age leaders teach that Jesus is neither God nor the Christ. They emphasize that Christian principles must be discredited and abandoned. Flattery will be employed to entice the world into believing that man is God. Ultimately, Christians who resist the plan will be dealt with and the world purified of their existence. Their threefold creed of error can be summed up in this: there is no death, only reincarnation. Man is God, so he can do no right or wrong. Knowledge of self, primarily through contact with the spirit world, is salvation and power. Their path is to outlaw all present religious practices and symbols of Orthodox Judaism and Christianity. They threaten violence and even extermination of Jews, Christians, and Muslims who fail to cooperate. The New Age leaders have said that the plan is progressing very well. Some project the year 2000 as the key date for the dramatic appearance of this world leader. Others believe that the event may occur at any time. How widespread is this New Age movement? They are in every city, an institution in the world. They are in the United Nations, prominent scientific, legal, and medical circles, and even at the congressional and cabinet levels of the U.S. government. You need to know that if you are a Christian, a biblical Christian who believes in the Word of God, you are a primary target for the plan. It is time to test the spirits, as John tells us in 1 John 4:1-3. This is written by the Reverend Jonathan Wilson. Now, may I say to you, that is a very fine article, and it does describe the New Age movement better than I could give it to you in a brief time. And it reveals how dangerous it is. You and I are living in the day of the most dangerous cults, the most dangerous isms, the most dangerous religions that have ever appeared. And it's easy for God's people to be taken in. I get letters constantly from people who have gone off in one of these, thinking it was some Christian movement that had a little spiritual life to it. And they find out that they've gotten in one of the worst heresies that there is. Well, let me say that on our side, those that are conservative today, we have not been alert. And there is spiritual deadness today in our so-called conservative churches. We need today a spiritual movement, and only a real spiritual movement can drive all of this satanic trash back where it came from. And we need today to pray for a spiritual movement in our churches. I think that is probably the greatest need of the hour, is a spiritual movement in the church today. And let us get away from this idea of building big churches and having big crowds and that sort of thing, when actually people are entertained, they're not taught the Word of God. And today, as one man said to me, he says there's more cosmetic Christians today than there are real Christians. Today, even fundamental Christianity is taking on a different complexion than it's ever had before. So that you and I think, live at the most dangerous point in the history of the world. So what we need to do is to stay close to the Word of God and to stay close to the Lord today. Be very easy to be led astray in days like this, when you see the prominent people, that is prominent in the sense that they're the ones that are on television today. And so many of them have gone this route. Well, they know a great deal about politics. They know a great deal about acting. They know a great deal about many things. But they do not know the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. And that is a great need of the hour.